It's Copycat Friday, you'll love it.
Hey, I'm back, I like to be back. Woo. Hey, I'm back, I like to be back. Woo. Hey, I'm back, I like
to be back. That's right, guys, I am back from my holiday, and I'm glad to be back, because I really missed Copycat. Also, I want to thank Lorenzo for doing such a great job last week. Really loved the video, and especially the effect. You're a natural. But enough talking, let's get to work. Now, each week before we make a Copycat Friday, we always brainstorm together. And this week we had the idea to create something from Tenet. However, we had a light brain meltdown when Jill tried to explain the time reverse principle. That's why Lorenzo and I went back to the drawing board and found ourselves a super cool body shield effect from the upcoming movie Dune. But that is not what we are doing today. Today we are doing K-pop transitions. This week Stray Kids released a new music video called Backdoor, and it's full with simple but fun transitions. And that is what we are making today. However, to get back to the Dune body shield effect, if you want to know how to make that, let us know in the comments below. Maybe we can do it next week. But now, let's start with the first transition. Take it away, Lorenzo.
Sorry, Janik. But anyways, the first transition will be this one right here, where we cut to different angles of the same shot, but keep one point of the face exactly on the same spot, giving these cuts a less harsh feeling. Just take a few shots of your talent in different angles and drag that to After Effects. Go to the tracker panel and click Stabilize Motion. Move your tracking point on the nose and make sure the boxes are big enough, so your tracking doesn't go all over the place. And simply hit Analyze Forward. Once done, hit Apply and press OK. Just do the same steps for all your clips. Put them on top of each other, decrease the opacity, and start aligning the nose of each shot. Don't forget to increase the scale so the edges of the clip disappear. Finally, put the opacity back to 100% and put your clips behind each other. You can also do this manually inside of Premiere Pro, or you can make this simplified version which Jordi explained in last week's video. Link in the description below.
Now before the second transition, let's transition to Storyblocks Video, a huge library of video stock clips perfect to speed up your editing workflow. You can always find the shot that you are looking for on Storyblocks Video. Now besides having great stock footage, they also have a ton of video assets such as transitions, light leaks, motion design assets, and of course, easy to customize After Effects templates. Like you can hear, Storyblocks Video is perfect for every filmmaker. And for only one single price per year, you can download an unlimited amount of video assets. So to start downloading, click on the first link in the description below. And now, let's create that second transition, which is going to be this light flash transition. Of course, we are doing this practical. We already have our main setup where we can dance, but we need an extra super strong light that we can turn on quickly. And that's where the Aperture Nova comes in, a remote controlled LED panel. We place this off screen, point it directly at our dancer, set it to the brightest setting and turn it off. Now, let your dancer do his thing, but let him do a certain big movement like swinging his arms. On this movement, turn on the light and also do a small camera bump. Then for the second shot, switch the location and your outfit. Start with the lights turned on, let your dancer do the same movement, and also do that small camera bump. However, now you need to turn off the light in the movement, so your dancer is well lit again and not overexposed. Then in Premiere Pro, make a cut in both movements and place them against each other. Then to enhance the effect, use an adjustment layer on top and animate the exposure in the Lumetri panel from 0 to bright to 0 again. And this will stitch it all together.
For our third transition, we'll be playing around with moving elements, which you can see right here. Taking the shot is fairly easy. Make sure you have two talents in it, one in the foreground and one in the back. Let your talent in the front do something, and after that, pull your focus to the second talent. Now, leave your focus on the same distance and take an empty shot. Our second shot doesn't need to be anything special, so just shoot whatever you want. And now it's time for Premiere Pro. Put your clip on the timeline and go to the point where you want your assets to move around. Make a cut on this point. Copy this two more times by holding Alt and dragging it up. On the third layer, mask out your foreground talent And don't forget to animate this a few frames. On the second layer, do exactly the same for your background talent. Go to the first layer and replace the clip after the cut with your empty shot. And nest your second and third layer. Now we'll add our final animation. To do this, we'll be using the transform effect so we can add motion blur later on. Add this to all three of your clips and give them an animation. Don't forget to add Easy Ease Out and Easy Ease Into your keyframes. Enable the motion blur by unchecking the Use Composition Shutter Angle. And of course, choose a shutter angle. Let's nest these three layers together and again, add the transform effect to it. Here, you can put a slight zoom animation to it. Again, Easy Ease your keyframes. Finally, move this layer one layer up and add your second shot under it. Again, put a slight zoom on it to match the zoom of your first shot. And there you go, easy as that.
Then the last transition, which is going to be a simple one, a foot wipe. Now for this transition you need one specific thing, and that is the same floor in both shots. So this means you don't need to change your location. However, if you want you can of course, just have the same floor. But what you do need to change is your outfit. Then your dancer can dance and on a certain moment you wipe down with the camera towards the dancer's foot and stop there. In the second shot, try to start with the exact same framing as you ended in the first shot. Next, wipe up again and reveal the dancer with some fresh new clothes. Very important, don't set your shutter speed too high because we need the motion blur to hide stuff. Then in Premiere Pro we can simply combine them with a cut in both movements. Match the two shots with the position and scale, maybe even use a simple short crossfade, and if you want, you can always nest everything together and use the speed ramp to enhance the movement. And that was it for this week, guys. But I still owe you a Janik Fun Fact Fountain! Did you know that K-pop is a real industry? Management agencies in South Korea look for new idols or K-pop singers, in other words, at a very young age. They train them in music, dance and language skills, preparing them for their debut. And apparently training such an idol costs around a few million dollars. That's one perfect running K-pop machine. And that was it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you Storyblocks Video for the support. And like always, stay creative.
It's Copycat Friday. You'll love it.
Hey, I'm back. I like to be back. Ooh. Hey, I'm back. I like to be back. Ooh. Hey, I'm back. I like to be back. Ooh. Hey, I'm back. I like to be back.
It's Copycat Friday. You'll love it.